Everybody, welcome to exercise 17-3. On January 1st, 2020, high and lowest company purchased 12% bonds having a maturity value of $300,000 for $322,744. The bonds provide bondholders with a 10% yield. They are dated January 1st and mature January 1st, 2025, with interest received on January 1st of each year. High and lowest uses the effective interest method to allocate unamortized discount or premium. The bonds are classified and held to maturity category. So this is going to be bonds as an investment. So when we bought the bonds originally on 1/1/20, so we're going to have cash go out the door. And the cash that went out the door was $322,744.44. And over here, we're going to have a bonds investment in bonds. And for this investment in bonds, we are going to be recording this right over here at right over here at 322,744. Okay. And let's see if I screwed this up. Nope, I got it right, part of it right. Okay. So this is how we're going through and recording it. Okay, so when I look at the bonds, basic record. Okay, so the bond amortization schedule. So here my carrying value is going to be 322. $322,744. Okay, and so the bonds pay cash for, it's going to be 12% times 300,000 or $36,000. Okay, however, the bonds provided the bondholders with a yield. So the cash paid for interest is going to be the stated rate of 12% times the face value, or 300,000. So my interest revenue, they're providing me with a 10% yield. So I'm going to multiply this by the carrying value by 10%. And let's see if this works. So the amortization, basically the premium amortization, is going to be the difference between this and this one here. And so my ending carrying value is going to be 322 minus this premium amortization here. Ultimately, this investment's going to have to get down to 300,000. So it would probably be, and this probably wouldn't be just shown as a premium amortization. I probably would just be crediting the investment in bonds. So let's go through and let's just keep on going through and working this out. So 2021, 2022, 2023, 2024. Okay, so end of the year is beginning. So over here, getting this. So my interest revenue is going to be 31,902. The cash paid for interest is never going to change. So here, my premium amortization is going to be 4,098. I subtract this here from this. And then let's see if we can get this to work. Ah, there we go. Amazing. So we know it's at a premium, and it's because I went through and I paid more. So I paid 322 instead of paying 300. So I paid more than what the bonds were worth. And that's because they had a stated rate of 12%. And if they were priced to do a 10% yield, then the amount of the, this is really going to be determining my interest revenue. So on, it's asking us to do the journal entry for December 31st, 2020. I'm receiving cash for $36,000. And I'm also going to be recording interest revenue over here of $32,274. So my difference is going to go to my investment in bonds. And this is going to be essentially the amortization of that premium. Okay. All right. So over here to record interest revenue. Okay. And then this 12/31/21, I'm essentially going to use the same things right over here. This is still going to be 36. My investment in bonds, this is right over here, the 4,098. And then my difference between these two is going to be 31,902. So that's how we do exercise 17-3. So if you want to have some more fun though too, and just by way of review, how are these bonds priced? So when you look at this in terms of being a five-year bond, and just so we know how you got the, how did we get that 322,000? Well, the cash, there's two components to bond valuations. There's going to be the face value, and then there's going to be the interest. So my interest expense, or my interest, cash paid for interest, or cash received for interest is going to be 36,000. When I go to the tables, what I'm going to do, so this is the cash I'm receiving. This is going to be 300,000 times 12%. And this here is going to be 300,000. This is the face value of the bond. When I go to the tables, I'm going to go to present value of a dollar. This is going to be five periods at 10%. This is going to be the present value of an annuity of a dollar, five periods at 10%. So let's see if we can find an annuity table. Oh yeah, I'm torturing some accounting students right now. Let's take a look. So over here, let's go here to, where's my 1A? Let's see, maybe this will work. Oh, perfect. Okay. So right over here, we've got present value table. Okay, so we got over here, we've got five periods at 10%. So this is gonna be 0.62092. And we use this for lump sums. Okay, then for the annuity, I'm gonna go over here and go to the present value of an annuity of a dollar. Five periods at 10% or 3.79079. So the total bond proceeds Wow, look how that works. So that's how they came up with that number. So this is kind of behind the scenes if you want to kind of see that, but that's how they actually came up with that 322,744. For those of you who have not had present value yet like this, probably be a good time for you to let's go ahead and start learning that. It'd be a good idea to do that. So In any event, I want to thank you for joining me here today, and I look forward to seeing you on the next video. Have a great one.